Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Now, I have done well over 1900 YouTube videos, and I have a website also, and I need the help to arrange them so that people can find them, you know, wherever they with ease. Now, you know, if you want to find something, it is very difficult, and people have to go to the playlist and all that, you know, to find out, or by other means. So if we can arrange these things in a website that can easily locate and search, you know, the videos they want, and it will be much appreciated. Now, I have many articles written. They are also in a disarray, and I will put those via website also in the description, so you can have a look and see if you can come up with some suggestions. So I've written articles mostly in English. Some are in Punjabi too, you know, in my native language. Same YouTube videos, there are some in Punjabi, and mostly they are in English. So whenever you do the work for God, or helping other people in the name of God, then you do it on a voluntary basis. That means you do not expect any payment. And if you are doing something in the name of God and you are expecting payment, or you are getting paid, then God won't give you anything. That you have no desire to have His word. So those who seek His word, who have the desire of His word, they only appreciate what I'm doing. So this type of knowledge is very easy, like ABC. It's not difficult. I have not learned any books, you know. But if you search the answers in your heart, and you will find them. So that's why Christianity and Sikhism is a religion of the heart and not of the books. In the books you will find letters. Letters are useful, but they are milk, you know. But unless you have a capacity to understand the gospel or the parables, what is hidden underneath, then you are doing more damage than good. So let's preach gospel, because the time ahead is not easy one. People have made atomic bombs, and they are made to be used, and if they are not making of their own will, unless our Father willeth, nothing happens. So it is the will of our Father that people are making atomic bombs, that the end to the injustices, to the atrocities which one human being do to the other, that all that things that are happening, they can be put to an end, and a fresh start in the world could be made. When this atomic war will happen, not many people will survive, as you know it. Those who take to sword shall die by the sword. So the only people who will survive will be the Bush people. They are in Brazil and South America and Africa continent. They don't make bombs. They will survive. Only there will be internal fighting, which would last long if the tribal instinct is strong. Because this world or the land belongs to the tribes and not to the Christian, Muslim, Hindu or Sikh. They are spiritual self. To them belong the your own physical body. So people who are propagating that and talk in terms of Hindu, Sikh and Muslim, they are infidels or they are the Antichrist. Anybody who has the knowledge of the will of our Father, he will talk in terms of tribe, because this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam. So he will try in terms of tribes. So anybody who talk in terms of Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, you know, you hear some speeches being made by politicians, by the so-called dog-collared priest. They are all speeches in the name of Antichrist. They does not lead to peace, but to war. No wonder, you know, people say religion stands for peace, but it is creating wars. Wars are made because they are speak falsehood. Falsehood are abstract lies, which you cannot understand if you are not a sensible person. For example, in the churches they claim Christ died, Christ rose on third day. Now most of you may be just taking it, you know, without any notice. But think it deeply. Christ stands for his word, and that became flesh in the name of Jesus. So Jesus was the name of his physical body. So his physical body died, not Christ. Christ was in the beginning and he is forever. So this small thing I'm telling you, and if you look into your books, you know, this Nicene Creed, which was the nonsense creed created by the Antichrist, you will see such things over there. But people are still carrying on as if it is true. They don't bother. So if you don't bother, you won't learn anything. Because these small things will tell you that a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. So when a Jew is inwardly spiritual, never born, how can he die? Thing that is born is tribal self, which could be Benjamin, Levite, Judah tribe, and so. They are born tribal people, and tribal people die. That's why in the Revelation, all those who will be saved, 144,000, they are all mentioned by tribes and not Jews or the chosen people. In fact, chosen people are spiritually sick people that needed the doctor most. And Christ Jesus came among them, among his own, as he stated in John, and his own hated him. They loved darkness. and that darkness created blind guides, leading the blind into the pits of death, which were holocausts. So holocausts were the making of the Jews themselves. If they have not rejected Christ, they would not have suffered the Holocaust. The Antichrist Messianic Jews, when they overpower the church, they bring in the rotten old Torah, written Torah, which is the old cloth full of holes, which were forbidden. So they bring in to attract their old customers. Remember Matthew 12, 43 to 45. The evil spirit could not find a rest, you know, a green pastures. So he was moving around in arid places. Arid places mean devoid of any money, mammon. So they were not, could not make mammon, you know, going around. So they said, oh, let's go back to our old people. And then they went to the old people. They found them much devoted to God. And much, the house was much in order. So they sat in the churches. And then they bring in the written Torah to attract them at the bait. So when that bait was put in the church, then these Jews, they flocked to church. And that's how they made the church number grow. But remember that Peter, he is the key, a great gatekeeper to the church of God. He would not allow a liar into the church. So when these Messianic Jews, they started to love mammon, they did not mind if the liars come. So far they give their property to them. Widows' mite they live on. They turn stones, simple-minded people, into bread. Remember how this Pope, you know, today, he put on these white washed clothes? At whose expense? As widows' mite. He has no conscience, nothing. So in Jesus, because when he died, his mission was to introduce to us our Father through his word. So that's why Jesus said, those who have perceived me have perceived my Father. So Christ Jesus had introduced to us our Father through his word. So if we do his will, then we are worshipping our Father in honor of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, because he introduced to us. So anything we do, we honor our brother Christ Jesus, and at the same time we glorify our Father when we preach gospel. So let's preach gospel and help each other. You have certain skills, you put in. I have certain skills, I put in, without charge, voluntary basis, and with full backing of your heart. Not that you are doing this out of any obligation or anything. We are praising our Father God. We are not rendering our own praises. So let's preach gospel and spread his word through as many avenues as possible. There's no copyright on my material. You can translate it into German, French, Russian, any language you want. So our Father God bless you, and let's do his will.